good afternoon, good evening, good night, good day, good morning, good dawn. My name is Martin Luther King. People call me Jack. If today is your first time of subscribing to this channel, congratulations. If today is your first time of meeting us on this channel, don't forget to subscribe, because there is so much packed here that you are going to learn for yourself. You are going to find out a lot of information that's so valuable, that's going to live on for the next decades. Thank you for joining us once again on MTNO Business Complex. Today, I'm going to take you through the introduction of snail farming as a beginner, the pros and the cons, the things that you need to know to start your snail farm as a beginner. Maybe you are a youth, maybe you are jobless, maybe you are broke, you don't know what to do, you don't have anything in mind to do. I'm here to encourage you and then motivate you as a snail farmer so that you can also start your own snail farm and then you can start making money for yourself. Introduction to snail farming. We are going to talk about some characteristics about snail farming. All right. Every snail farm has to be successful. No snail farm has to crash down. So before you can have a successful snail farm, you have to know all these characteristics. Number one, snails are hermaphrodite. Snails are hermaphrodite. That means they have both the male sexual organ and the female sexual organ. It means every snail has a sperm and it also has ovaries. All right? So this is the number one secret that makes snail farming very profitable above all other farming businesses, like catfish farming, like grass cutter farming, like piggery, like rabbit farming, goat farming, cow farming, etc., etc. Because if you have 50 pieces of snails in your farm, all these 50 pieces can start laying when the season is due. So it makes snail farming ahead of all other farming businesses. Number two, snails are omnivores. Snails are omnivores. Now, when we say an omnivore, we simply mean an animal or a creature that can eat from plant source of food, at the same time can also feed from animal source of food. So snails can eat plants and they can also eat animals like fish or any other form of food or feed provided from animals. So this is the particular kind of characteristics that makes snails so much easy to rear. You can take absolute and total control of them so easily by giving them enough feed, which is in your own surrounding. So it makes it so easy to rear snails without spending much on their feeds. Number three, snails have some cultural barriers and religious barriers. This means that anybody who wants to venture into snail farming will have to look at the society that he lives in. Yes, the environment, the society, the community, and the locality. The kind of people you live with, or the kind of people in the society that you live with. These are the people who are going to make your farm successful or make your farm go down. So if you live in a community where they don't eat snails, you have to know how to go about your snail farming. Because in Africa, major communities or many people don't like snails, but it is about 70% delicacy for especially people in the West Africa region. So make sure you know your culture and your religious beliefs before you decide to venture into snail farming. Number four, snails can lay enough eggs and can produce a conducive environment for hatchery. This is an added advantage to the farmer. That means snails can lay so much eggs for you. We shall come on that topic, but I would just want to talk about the Akatina. Snails which are in the category of Akatina can lay up to 1,500 eggs per year. So it is so advantageous that one snail can produce 1,500. That's so much. We will get to that point in our subsequent episodes. Number six, snails love cool or humid environment. Snail love cool, not cold, cool and humid environment. Yes, that means if a snail finds itself in a hot weather, it begins to die. So you have to make sure your snail farm is always cool and the environment is humid. With moisture or the humidity is okay. Number six, snails hibernate or they estivate during the dry season. So if you are a snail farmer, the best thing you have to do is you make sure that you keep your snails active throughout the year. All right, you have to make sure that your snails are always active. That means you will have to be sprinkling enough water on them so that they don't estivate. The estivation or the hibernating system or season is when the snail covers its face with a white scale because it feels that there is a dry season or the weather has become very dry. So it has to go into dormancy for at least 4 to 6 months. If this happens as a commercial farmer, you are going to be at a loss. Because the snails will not be active, they will not eat so that they will be able to produce enough eggs for you. They are going to be in dormancy for a long period of time. So make sure always there is enough water sprinkled in your farm on your snail to keep them always active as a commercial snail business person. Number seven, snails are nocturnal animals. Snails are nocturnal animals. When we say nocturnal, we mean snails are active in the night and they sleep in the day. So they sleep in the day, they wake up in the night to hunt for food and water. So make sure that you don't keep any electricity or light in your pen in the night so that the snails can come out and eat. When there is light in your pen, they will never come out because they feel that it is still day, so they will never come out to eat. So make sure that you give them enough food in the night, you sprinkle enough water on them in the night, and you put off any light that is close to them so that they can have enough time to hunt for food and produce for you. Congratulations for knowing most of the characteristics of snails. These are the basic characteristics that every snail farmer should be made aware of. The next topic, we are going to talk about the requirements that is needed for a snail farm. All the basic requirements that anybody needs to start a profitable snail farm. Number one, it is always advisable to have a good species of the snails. Yes. Many people go into the market and then they just grab anything they find and then they come to start a snail farm. Some of these snails in the market will carry some bacteria, some pathogens and some fungus that might not help your snails to survive or to produce as a commercial business snail farmer. So make sure that you get your snails from a colleague snail farmers who have been in the system for many years, so that they can give you a correct species that you can also start to grow. I always also advise to get a hybrid, which is the best because they can survive in all weathers. Yeah. Number two, soil structure. You need a good soil structure for effective growth and the survival of your snails. Many people who don't know many of these things just start their snail and then get any kind of soil into their pen. Today, I'm going to show you the kind of soil that you need in your snail farm, which will help effective growth for your snails. All right. Number one, you need a loamy soil. A loamy soil. Everybody who knows loamy soil knows that it is the best soil that is used for the production of crops and rearing of animals in agriculture. You can also use black soil. You can also use black soil. Now, when we say a loamy soil simply is the kind of soil that we find in our farms, in our cocoa farms, palm farms, coconut farms, where you can plant anything. You can just go get some of the soil, bring it home, treat it, and then keep them in your pen so that your snails can survive and grow effectively. There are some soils that are not recommended in snail farming. Some of these soil include clay soil and sandy soil. The reason why mostly I don't recommend clay soil is that it has the capability of retaining so much water that will make your pen become a waterlogged. Should in case you try to sprinkle water in your pen, that it becomes choked with water. That means the snails will not be able to survive. And then if you use sandy soil also drains so much water. So immediately you sprinkle water on the soil, the water vanishes, and then the snails are left vulnerable. Number three, availability of quality water. Not any water, quality water. Snails are like humans. They are like every creature. They drink water. They need water to survive. In most cases, there was a woman who called me from Canada. She has this snail farm, and for a year, the person who was taking care of the snails never gave them water. So the snails were dying, and there was a stunted growth. All right? So every snail farmer should make sure the locality or the environment, the situated place for his snail farm business, has to have a quality or a good source of water. All right? Most people use tap water. I normally don't really recommend tap water. Before you can use tap water, there is something you have to do. You have to pass it through an activated charcoal so that it can take off the chlorine and other chemicals that have been used in processing of the water. Yes, but if you get a river water or if you get a well water, it is always advisable. And every time that you start your snail farm, a season will come, which will be the dry season, and the snails will go to estivation or hibernation. So this is when you will be needing the water in large quantities so that you can be sprinkling your water on the snails every day so that the snails can be active for you all the time. Access to food. Access to food. This includes both natural and artificial foods. I first of all told you that snails are omnivores. They eat from both plant source and animal source. There are places where you can keep your snails where they can have natural food around them. We will come to the types of pens, and then I will be talking deeply on that. But snails can eat anything natural, and then you can also formulate your feed for them. When we come to formulation of feed, I don't teach that for free. Anybody who will want to go into formulation of feed, when you chat me privately and you give me a token, I'm going to take you through all the steps, all the materials and the ingredients that you need to formulate a feed that will make your snails to grow very faster, and so that you can sell them and make money reasonably. Number four, good housing structure. Now, when we come to snail farming, the housing structure is the most important thing that is needed in every snail farm. As human beings, in the night we go to sleep, snails also need their houses to sleep in. So every snail farmer has to make sure he gets a good housing or pen for the snails. This is where all the controversies about snail farm surrounds. People want to use different kinds. We are going to talk deeply on that. People use the car tie. People use the open trench. People use the wooden structures. People use the concrete pens. And others also use the greenhouse. So when we get there, we will talk about that. But all that you need to know is that you need a good housing structure that can house your snails for you so that you may not lose them. The main reason why you need housing for your snails is this should be in one of the characteristics. Snails are defenseless. They are unable to protect themselves from their prey or their people. Different things. So if you have a good structure, you have to provide enough security for your snails so that nobody comes to steal them, no animal comes to eat or to kill them, so that you will be running at a loss. You need to do that, which will help you and help your business to survive. Knowledge, that's number six. You should have knowledge in any form of business that you will want to go into. You should have enough knowledge on every business. This is why it is always advisable to read wide, train yourself, and then you go into snail farming. Don't just get up and then go into snail farming. Because of this, I have an ebook. I have an ebook that I give out to my client and my customers. If you DM me, I'll give you an ebook that will give you enough information for just a token. There is something we call earning, learning before earning, earning after learning. You need to learn, build up yourself with knowledge before you begin to earn money. People think you just get up because this is snail farming so easy. You just get up, you jump into it, and then you start making money. It doesn't work like that. Congratulations once again for knowing all the materials or the necessary conditions that everyone needs in order to start a good snail farming. So these are the basic requirements that everybody needs in order to be a successful snail farmer. If you have any question, you can write it under the comments below. I will be reading and I will be explaining into details any form of question that you need. Now, let us go to the next topic. We are going to talk about some other things that you need to know about your snail farming. Number one, effective business and marketing strategies. You should have effective marketing strategies. These should be included in your business plan. Most people start businesses without having a plan. If you don't have a plan for your snail farm, I have a wide and opened, and how do I say it? I have elaborated it. A big, nice, restructured, redesigned business plan for snail farming. If you contact me, I have a business plan sample for you. You can go through and then use it to draw your own business plan. If you give me a small token, I'm gonna give it to you for free. Yeah, so every business plan has to include effective marketing and business strategies. So you need some strategies that you are going to use to supply your snails. So there are hotels, there are restaurants, there are sideway food vendors, there are a lot of people who need snails in order to do their daily businesses. So if you know how to contact and capture these people in your business plan, it will be very easy for you. Imagine you have produced about 300,000 pieces of snails. How are you going to sell them? There should be a business plan. There are so much opportunities in business, snail farming business. So much. The opportunities are so huge. The opportunities are so huge. People can ship abroad. People can sell in the diaspora. People can sell in their locality. People can sell in the market. Even people will be chasing and be calling you for snails. Yes, I know the number of people who call me per day or who send me message on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, WhatsApp, looking for snails to buy. It is amazing. It is amazing. Now, some of the business opportunities in snail farming include the slime, meat consumption or meat production, the snail shell. So we are going to take each of them one after the other and then we will talk about them. Snail slime refers to the secretion or the liquid that is secreted by snails by their external body. people who have the connection to export these limes to foreign countries say it is really lucrative. They say they make so much money. The reason is that this is needed in large quantity for the making of cosmetics. So if you are into snail farming, make sure you get these connections. You are also able to extract this slime, and then you can also export it in large quantities, and then you can make so much money from it. Shells. Snail shells are so much in needed in large quantity, to the extent that people who produce animal feed use it as a source of calcium. So people who produce animal feed need the snail shells in large quantity so that they can produce calcium that will make their animals to grow strong and healthy bones and shells. That is number one. Other people who are in the ceramics and the paint industry also use the snail shells. So you can imagine the number of opportunities that you are going to get from the snail shells. Apart from the paint and the paper and the ceramics and the feed, the snail itself, the meat itself, is the main reason why some of us are into snail farming. You can produce large quantity of meat from snails. Many people have stopped eating red meat these days because of the large calories and the other health factors that are connected to it. So you make sure that you switch from red meat and come to snail meat. So many people are switching, and the meat consumption of snail is growing daily. People use it as barbecue, people use it as their delicacy, the food that they make. So it is, when you come to Ghana, snail meat is absolute expensive, yes, and it is very high in demand and very less in supply. Congratulations once again for joining this nice episode. In our next episode, I will be talking about species of snails and the type that is needed for commercial businesses in Africa and West Africa, and how we can go about them. Congratulations! In our next topic, we are going to talk about the species of snails, the type of the snails that we rear in Africa that is largely consumed and that is in large demand in Africa. So that's what we are going to talk about today. Number one, we have the Acatina acatina, that is AA. Number two, we have the Acatina marginata, that is AM. And then we have the Acatina follica, that is the AF. All these kind of snails fall under a category, which is a name given to them as the African land giant snails. They are the biggest kind of snails that have ever existed on the surface of the planet. So the African land giant snails, where we have the Acatina acatina, the AA, the Acatina marginata, the AM, and the Acatina follica, that is the AF. So we are going to take each and every one of them and then talk about them a little bit. AM, which is the Acatina marginata, according to some sources, is the largest of all the snails. Well, I haven't confirmed that, but let's take it that the AM is the largest of all the snails, of the hybrid snails, that is the African land giant snails. But the AA and the AF are very much needed for commercial purposes because of their laying abilities. The AM lays 5 to 40 eggs per clutch, and it can lay between 2 to 4 times in a season. The AM, which is the Acatina marginata, lays 5 eggs to 40 eggs per clutch, and it can lay like 2 to 4 times in a particular season or in a year. Yeah, the AA and the AF can lay up to from 200 to 400 eggs per clutch, and they can also lay for 3 to 5 times in a year. So you can see the difference. The AA and the AF can lay up to 400 per clutch, all right? And the AM can lay 5 to 40 per clutch. The AM start laying from 8 to 9 months, whilst the AA and the AF start laying from 6 months. So imagine the huge difference. Yes, the AM start laying from 8 months, and the AA and the AF start laying from 6 months to 8 months going. Note, for the farmer to make more profit, it is always advisable to go for the AA and the AF so that it can reproduce and then grow into a viable commercial business. Congratulations for the end of this episode. I'm going to end this episode here, and in our next episode, I will be talking about the types of the pens, the types of pens that you need to construct for your snails. There should be differences. We have the growing pen, we have the hatching or the hatchery pen, and then we have the breeding pen. We will talk about each of them, and then we will talk about the types, the materials, the formats and the formulas that you need in order to raise or create a pen that will be able to sustain your snails for a greater profitability. Thank you so much. My name is Martin Luther King. This is MTNO Business Complex. Make sure you subscribe to this channel. Anything that you don't understand, I'm going to pin my number on the screen. Make sure you contact me by WhatsApp or email. Ask any question. Ask me anything you need to know. I will be available to explain to you. Wherever you are in the world, in Africa, in West Africa, in East Africa, in Canada, in US, in Australia, wherever you are, you can contact me on WhatsApp, +233-5540-52555. And I will be giving you enough information for free that you need to know. Thank you. Subscribe to this channel. Share with your friends, those who are jobless, those who need jobs, those who have money and they don't have anything to do with their money, or they are confused on where to start from. Let them contact me. I'm going to take them through. A lot of people contact me each day. By God's grace, I'm growing and I'm also training people. I'm giving them people hope every day, every night. Thank you. Subscribe, share, like, comment. Bye-bye.